It's,
I think,
really
every
bad.
Time I see you, your phone's low.
Does any? Do you know anyone else who does that?
No, I think it's just you.
Okay, I don't know what that means, but it's just the truth. Hi, everybody. Okay.
Welcome to Harbor Talk. Each week, I bring on a guest to talk about three taboo topics introduced in 3 minutes. Before the show, I cook the guest breakfast. After the show, the guest and I usually talk about those topics in depth. My next guest is Natalie Friend. Natalie.
Yes.
Are you ready to do some Harbor Talk?
Absolutely.
Okay, well, wonderful. We are starting the timer in 3, 2, and 1. So what's the first thing that you'd like to talk about today?
Diet culture.
Okay, what about diet culture is taboo to you?
Well, I think we don't talk about enough. For me, like, you know, you see on social media, right? You know, everyone's selling these detox teas and these things like that. And, you know, there's this expectation that you have to diet, right? Even when you don't need to. I mean, most people don't need to, right? It's something that you, I think you should only do, you know, if your doctor is telling you, right, for medical reasons. They're the one who can tell you what you need to be doing to change your body and change your diet. But there's all these messages, like, online, social media, especially in, like, Instagram, for example, really pushing you to like change your body and watch what you eat. And we don't really talk about how harmful that is.
Totally. And I know I've seen, you know, these instances and even news stories about people who go on diets, but literally it's just temporary.
Yeah.
It's temporarily something that people do in order to look or feel a certain way. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, what does it mean for it to be long-term and sustainable?
Yeah, exactly. And it's, yeah, and that's the thing is when you see people dieting, it's never about your long-term health, right? It's about, oh, like prom's next week and I want to look great. You know, it's all these like drastic changes, which can be really harmful for not just your body, but your psyche. It's never about your long-term health. And I think if you're going to diet, there are people who diet and who diet for health reasons. And, you know, absolutely, I think that, you know, if that's a medical choice for you and if that's about sustainable change and about your real health, I think absolutely. But most of the time when I've seen it, it's been detrimental for sure.
Interesting. That's a good point. So what would you say is the second thing that you'd like to talk about today?
So someone asked about being friends with your ex.
Oh, yes. Okay. Why do you feel like that's taboo to talk about?
Well, you know, what's funny is, I feel like we kind of live in a world of drama nowadays. Everybody loves the gossip. Everybody loves drama and this and that. And like, I think we're seeing a decline in the ability for people to just be mature adults. And, you know, being friends with your ex is an example. You know, people expect if there's a breakup, they expect it to be this huge storm, you know, and all these fights and this and that. And you never speak or see each other again. You're immediately enemies. But I don't really ascribe to that belief because, you know, relationships are about love and they're about coming together with somebody. And I think, you know, the end of a relationship is very sad. But for me, relationships are, I value them and I value the people I'm with. And so, you know, regardless of how that ends, I always want to keep them in my life in some form. So, you know, it's funny. The taboo thing is to me, doing the right thing, right? Like, which is being mature and maintaining that friendship and that connection.
I admire that because I know I'm guilty of basically shutting people out because I'm just insecure about something in myself. It wasn't until I've come out about my bisexuality that I would want to cut off my relationships because I've ultimately learned in myself, I'd never wanted to share that with my partner and I thought they would judge me.
Yeah.
Although the timer went off, it don't matter. Let's talk about the third thing for today. And that is?
So the legacy of racism in the United States, in particular, looking at discrimination today and discrimination from 60 years ago and beyond and kind of where we're at. And for me, the taboo thing is we don't talk about it. You know, I've learned a lot recently about civil rights and about the movement. And we don't talk about the fact that it was 60 years ago. People are alive today who were on both sides of the issue, right? So I think, you know, we don't educate students. We don't, it's not part of our system in any way to address these things. And they're still alive. You know, we still have fundamental systemic suppression, like alive and well today. And, you know, we act like it's all past, like it happened. We only talk about the civil rights issue and slavery and racism and discrimination in the past tense.
Totally. And how it's become modernized mm-hmm. through the mass incarceration of African-American mm-hmm. men and women in our current system today, and how there are so many more penalties against African-American men and women today. It just really makes you questions and think when you have like an outside lens and you're really looking above it. It's like, mm-hmm. why do we treat each other that way?
Yeah.
Why do you think we treat each other that way? Why do you think racism has become modernized today mm-hmm. in the way that it has?
Yeah, absolutely. I think a lot of it is education. And the lack of education we have speaks to the fact that it hasn't gone away, you know? We don't educate students about. I didn't learn about civil rights in my public school.
Didn't really either. I had a short unit about it, but it was nothing.
Exactly. You know. And so, like, if we're not teaching people today, we definitely weren't teaching them yesterday or the day before that, you know? Right. So our parents and the people who lived through this movement were never re-educated, right? You know, we never looked closely into our history as a society and tried to learn from it. We tried to close the chapter and move on, which isn't how this works. You know, you have to face, you know, as a society, we have to face our culpability. We have to face the system that we built is a system designed to oppress people.
Yeah.
And just because we pretend that it no longer oppresses people doesn't mean that it still doesn't. So right. I think if we want to move past systemic racism and bias built in to the justice system or even into our hearts, we have to look closely at our history and start trying to learn from it.
Mm. You're very, very wise, Natalie. I love that you came onto this show today. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate you. Yeah. Thank you all very, very much for watching Harbor Talk today. Feel free to follow me on Instagram because she had to submit 2 taboo topics from you. So mm-hmm. feel free to do that. All right. You ready to do it for realsies?
Yep.
Okay. Here we go. You ready? Mm-hmm. Pause, play, try to be kind, and keep making a difference. We'll see you guys soon.